Hello and welcome to a rather unique lab update. So in this case, lab is the road and the newly converted Touran. I just came back from this road trip that went from Kassel to Mannheim and then to Saarbrücken, which is like roughly 400 kilometers, and a bit of driving around locally, being 1100 kilometers in total. So, while everything went very smooth on the way there, it went a bit adventurous on the way back. See for yourself. Good morning, everybody. So, today we will attempt a long-range test of the newly built Touran. And I've loaded it up with quite some luggage. So under the blanket here you will see a full Nissan Leaf pack that I'm going to deliver to a friend for his Audi A2 conversion, my bike, and some miscellaneous luggage and a lot of charging cables. I've trickle charged the car all night using the simple Schuko plug, so I should be good to go. Only thing that worries me, the car has developed a bit of vibration yesterday in the drivetrain, and I'm hoping this is not going to get worse as I go. All right, so we are ready to go. Car is fully charged, like I said, and I've come up with something very innovative to look instrument cluster. Of course, the shortcoming of this innovation is if I turn the steering wheel, yeah, well, picture will turn as well. Anyway, let's go. All right, so we are on the move. Pretty low average consumption because we've been mostly rolling downhill. 1024, what else do we have? 320 kilometers of range. Yeah, I wish. Driven 2 kilometers so far, 14 kilometers per hour average. Hope that's gonna get better. 9 minutes since I took off from home. All right, we are cruising with cruise control on the Autobahn. This is actually a limited stretch, but yeah, at this point I'm not going to do any high-speed tests. Might do that later on when we're a bit closer to the destination. So, SOC has fallen off quite a bit already after 10 kilometers. But it always does that at the in the top end. Yeah, but still, I'm pretty confident our first charging stop is going to be after 86 kilometers. And we're going to reach that just fine, as already tested. Average consumption is climbing right now because we are on an uphill stretch. Let's see what it evens out at. Yeah, vibration is actually not audible right now at 5000 RPM. So, I'm confident it will not be a problem. Alright, so I've reached my first charging destination. And actually it was a bit too early. It was just down to 27%. And because with a car of that battery size, you have to kind of plan ahead a bit. Because the lower the state of charge, the faster the charging speed. And the shorter your brake. So normally, if I was a more experienced long-distance EV driver, I would have probably skipped that one and gone right to the next one. But in this case, we do not. So we have a charging current of 113 amps, and I've forgotten to add the power. So let's do that now. Power. Yes, charging, wow, charging at 43 kilowatts. I'm really happy with that. So yeah, we are now 82 kilometers into the trip. And we are in Stadt Allendorf, which is a bit, if you literally translate it, I've always been amused by that name. It means City Allen Village. Well, that's it. So, I will stay here for a few minutes. There's a Gesundheitszentrum, health centrum, where I'm currently charging. So I will go and see if I can drop something off. Yeah, and then we will continue going. Okay, so I've been here for 10 minutes and already our SOC has climbed from 27 to 64. But of course now it starts to taper off power, down to 21 kilowatts. But still, I am gonna charge to about 80%. Good, I've been here 20 minutes now. I think I've sufficiently charged for another 80 kilometers, so I'm good to go. Battery temperature has risen to 31. And I'm curious to see if it will actually drop now, because it's I think it's better ventilated than in the Leaf, because it's not encapsulated into its own enclosure and actually gets some wind through the exhaust tunnel. We'll see. Okay, let's stop charging. There's a really alarming smell right here, and I thought maybe my fast charging cable starts to melt, but it's gotta be something else. Good. So 11.2 kilowatt hours charged. Can I just press stop? Now I have to break out my card again. This is so that people don't interrupt your charging session. I gotta show your ID again. Well, is that a new problem? Oh, it stops making noises. So yeah, I should be able to pull it out. Am I? Oh, there was a clonk. Ah, there you go. Put this back. This was on the floor when I came. Look at that. Okay, all charged up. Let's go. I'm driving the same speed with cruise control, and this guy overtook me and now he slowed down again. Thank you very much. Well, let's not crash into him anyway, but really annoying. Okay, so my charging stop is just like, I don't know, 5 kilometers away, and I think I've run into a small problem, because maximum battery voltage, so the state of charge is 15, and maximum battery voltage is 3566 millivolts, and the minimum is 3377, and that drops really fast, so there's at least one cell that is emptying before all the others. So it's just about time to reach that charging stop. That was just about time. I could feel a power limit actually. The car wasn't accelerating much anymore because 3.3 volts in Nissan Leaf batteries is really low. It means empty. So, but now we're charging at 40 kilowatts. And I'm gonna stay here for a while, eat something. There's a thing to check the tire pressure. Why not do that? Now see, why do fossil drivers get a nice roof and can fuel up in the shadow? And us electric drivers have to be in the sun and stay there for a lot longer. Now another fun fact inside here. I actually just discovered a spider. So spiders do not get burned on EV rims, because the friction brakes don't generate any heat. And you can see that. I renewed the discs for TÜV and I've driven a couple of hundred kilometers by now. And they still have this original brush pattern. So they're like untouched. So wow, that's really good on regen. I've also used the time to up the tire pressure. Especially the rear tires were a bit low on pressure, so that should help efficiency a bit. So, interesting experience for me. I've driven this route 100 times in my diesel car. And I was hungry, so what I would have done in my diesel car, I would have just gone and then eat at my parents' house. But now, since I have to stop anyway, charge the car, I might as well charge myself. Yeah, currently charging at 44 kilowatts. Back to 43% state of charge. And battery temperature is rising, it's 38, but apparently that's not a reason for the BMS to throttle down, so all good. Awesome. So yeah, it's a different kind of travel. Works for me. Good success rate with the fast charging stations, they all worked with one card or the other. Charging speed's good. But I'm a bit worried about this experience with a large difference in cell voltages. Not sure what's going on. So far I was hoping the SOC would be fairly accurate. It was at about 15 and I was already getting a power limit. So not too happy with that. So I might not drive to my destination, which is now, let's see. My destination is now exactly 100 kilometers away. I mean, if I stay here long enough to drive 100 kilometers in one go without any high speed tests and silly things, I might as well not stop again. I'll see. I have some time to look at the map and figure out the best way. So yeah, I think I'll at least stay for another 20 minutes and then go on.
So check this out. They put overhead, what's it called, overhead line, power lines I suppose DC plus and minus, because it's two. Four semis. Is that really the future, or should you just put stuff on trains in the first place? What do you think? Oh yeah, that's semi-behavior. Oh man, you couldn't do that if you were engaged in those overhead power lines. You have to stay in your lane. So, what's the status? 15 kilometers to my next charge point, which is a bit close because we are only at like 50% SOC. I mean, I could just keep going the remaining 56 kilometers. I'm not sure. I'll just do a quick 10-minute charge stop. And then not risk getting stuck on the autobahn.
All right, one last charging session in Kaiserslautern. Yeah, that's where Rammstein is. Famous American airbase. Yes, so battery temperature is still stuck at around 40 degrees. Let me just go back inside. And we're getting a nice and steady 43 kilowatts of charging speed. Even though I believe the BMS would actually allow 50, but for some reason the charger, let's have a look. See, the charge limit is 49 and the charge current limit is 137 amps. But the charger delivers 112 amps, so apparently that's the maximum it will do, so still good enough. So overall, I've been driving at around 100-110 on the highway. And I think the average consumption now is 17 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers. And I'm quite okay with that. So yeah, last charging stop, and then I can do a high speed run to my final destination, Neunkirchen. Okay, so now I just want to show you how universal that gear really is. So I've pulled away from a traffic light. Acceleration is just fine, as you can see. Sorry for the steering movement. Okay, so now we're getting on the on-ramp. And that's to full acceleration. Stick it here in cruise control if you want. And the electric motor will rev happily at a constant 7000 RPM. In a petrol engine, you'd be shaken apart by now and would need hearing protection. So even though it doesn't rev very much higher than the petrol engine, it's just comfortable at constantly running at those high revs, and that's what makes different gears redundant. Okay, I've turned off regen now, so I can go into fourth gear and do a little
another high-speed test. Action guy tried to reach top speed in sixth gear and he just reached 145. So yeah, not the way to go. Consumption has risen quite considerably. Temperature has risen just a bit because the engine was all nice and cool. Sure, if it's possible to downshift. Yeah, I mean, it's still accelerating okay. Fast charging heaven here. I've been here for 1 hour now.
at an Eon charge point, and that has the specialty that it won't accept any of my RFID cards. So I can't start it right now, but instead I have to use the app. And that app, well, let's skip the details. So I've called into a new motion and shell, at Eon. And at last they just started the charging process from their, you know, headquarters. And, well, at least it doesn't seem to cost anything. Except quite a lot of time. Okay, so that's the deal, the first charging fail. Apart from that, everything has been working so far. So, I'm in the middle of a construction site right now, and the way here has been quite an adventure. I'll tell you about it. I still have a rather high pulse rate. So about 7 kilometers ago, again, I noticed that the car isn't really accelerating anymore. And state of charge was at like 12%, so I pulled over, and then I found out, oh, before I say that, today the shoulder is to be driven on because of high traffic. So you only have those emergency stop bays, so to speak, every now and then. Yeah, so state of charge 12%, but the BMS hadn't issued a power limit yet. So now I looked into the inverter, and there I have configured an under voltage limit at 330 volts, because I thought that was like the lowest voltage the Nissan Leaf cells would run it. But that just is not correct. So I lower that to 250 or something, because it's the BMS's job to tell the inverter when to throttle down. And the under-voltage limit just kicked in way too early. So while I was in the bay, I reduced it to 300 volts and went on. And then came what's called the Kasseler Berge. It's a couple of steep inclines on the Autobahn. And there, one thing I noticed was that my charging stop was closed, which is shit. And on top of that, the car slowed down again. And I stood in the middle of construction site on a steep incline, and the car would not move. And of course, that's how you make a lot of friends. So at a 180 pulse rate, I started scrolling around on my tablet looking for the issue, and I noticed the voltage had dropped actually to 270 volt. So I dropped the limit again to 200 volts. So then at least I could get here. And obviously this is a large construction site, so I talked to one of the guys who is working here and told him that, well, either I have to be towed or I use that charging stop over there. And he said, yeah, just if you can get there, just go there and charge, no problem. And to my surprise, the charger is actually in service. Okay, so I already charged to full now. Yeah, I think I learned something. Don't do a too low under voltage limit. So, I hope you liked this kind of mix of lab update and road movie. Obviously the last two bits were dubbed, not very professionally, because I read it, or I did the way back in German. So to have something for my German viewers. Yeah, so overall I'm quite happy, despite all the fails that went on, with the performance of the car. It drives fast, it charges, well, reasonably fast, just like the Nissan Leaf would. The consumption is really good, I think. If you are cruising at 100 kph, you would arrive at like 14 to 15 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers. And if you're cruising at like 120, let's say, you will probably arrive at like you will arrive at 17 to 18 kilowatt hours. Good. That's it for today, or for this week, in fact. See you next time. Bye-bye.